Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I have a very exciting video, at least exciting for me. I'm going to talk about all the books that I've been reading for the March-February time of the year. I didn't really read a whole lot in February, so I figured I would kind of combine these two because I did read a fair amount in March. It's still blowing my mind that it's April already, but I have a lot of books here, so I might as well just get into this. And I apologize if you can hear my air purifier in the background. I'm trying to drown out the voices of my family, so hopefully the audio isn't terrible in this. But yeah, I actually had a lot of really great ones in here, a couple that were maybe slightly problematic, but I'm excited to just get started with it. So I have my whole stack here. I think I have like 10 or 11 to go through, so I'm gonna try and go through as quick as I can. So I'm just gonna grab a random one. So the first one I'm gonna talk about is Gutter Child by J.L. Richardson, and hopefully I'm pronouncing that right. This book was so good. I really liked it. I think I ended up giving it 4 stars. Just because the only thing that held me back, I think, from giving this 5 stars was at the beginning of the book, because of the dialogue. Like, I had no idea how old the characters were supposed to be. Like, in my mind, they were like 12. Because, you know, Gutter Child, and just the way that they talked, like, that kind of seemed their age range. But then something happens, which I'm not going to spoil, that, like, oh, they're definitely not 12. I think they're actually 16, but yeah, I just think sometimes the dialogue could be a little bit juvenile for, like, the age that they were supposed to be. But the actual premise of this book is so cool. It's like a urban dystopian, but also deals really heavy with, like, race relations and, like, systemic oppression, and it's just a fantastic book. I would say that I would put warnings for sexual assault and obviously racism for this book, but I think that everybody should pick this up and give it a read. It's also I believe a Toronto author, so represent. I don't even know what that was. That was really weird. Anyways, this was great. Highly recommend. Yeah, make sure you pick it up. The next book I'm going to talk about is a classic, and it's The Great Gatsby. I finally got around to reading it. I can't believe I've never read it before. We were supposed to do it in high school, but my English teacher chose a different book instead. And this was decent. I think, I can't remember what kind of rating I gave it, maybe a 4 stars. It's a really quick read and an easy read, so I see why this is sort of the introduction that a lot of schools do into classics. I mean, there were a few parts that were incredibly racist. From this one character, and I can't remember what the name is, but Daisy's husband, is his name Tom or something like that? I can't remember. Anyways, there were some moments that really rubbed me the wrong way, but for the most part, it's an entertaining story. It's one that's sort of widely well known, and I mean, they made it into a movie, but, and I know I saw the movie, I just don't remember anything that happened. But yeah, it's a decent read, and a quick one. So if you're looking to foray into classics, I would recommend picking this one up. Alright, the next book I'm not going to talk about for too long because it was kind of like meh, but it's Big Magic by Elizabeth Gilbert. And this book, I think I read it in like literally an hour because, like, I don't know if you can tell from me just going like this, but there's like basically no substance in this. I don't know. It's fine if you're looking for like a motivational, like, self-help book about creativity or whatever, but like, there were no original ideas in this. Like, you don't really need to read this, but if you're looking for like a pick-me-up or whatever, if you're feeling sort of stuck right now, which I know a lot of people are, myself included, I mean, this didn't really do anything to help me, but maybe it could help you. I don't know. It's a really quick read though. I did it, yeah. You can kind of just skim read it and you get the idea. But I don't remember what I rated that. Maybe like 2 stars. Anyways, moving on. The next book I'm going to talk about, which I'm pretty sure I gave a 5-star, is A Concrete Rose by Angie Thomas. I am so happy I finally got to read this. In March, I believe, I read it. And it was so, so good. I just love Thomas's writing and just the way that she creates her characters. And I liked how this one wasn't hugely plot driven. It was more about like Maverick and like his journey and like the people around him and everything. Like, I think I did like The Hate U Give better, but this one was a very close second and it was very enjoyable to read. And I can't wait to see what else she does. So yeah, definitely this is one of my favorites in this like entire wrap-up. I was gonna say haul, but it's not a haul, this entire wrap-up. So yeah, if you take one thing away from this, is read this book. Anyways, okay, I'm gonna talk about The 7 Husbands of Evelyn Hugo next, which by Taylor Jenkins Reid. And this was another 5-star one for me. At the beginning, I wasn't really sure if it was gonna get all the way there, but this was just such an entertaining read and the story was really gripping. And I liked the writing for the most part. There were a couple areas that were maybe not my favorite writing wise, but I just, the plot was really interesting and the characters were really gripping. And I think it was an interesting take on fame and Hollywood and kind of morality and like what it means to be a good person, I think. And yeah, there's just lots of fun twists in this too that I didn't really necessarily see coming. And yeah, I'm really interested to read more of her work actually, because I've never read any of her other books. But I think Daisy Jones and the Six, which it says up here, was really popular, so I might have to add that to my TBR at some point, put it in my shopping cart next time I do a book haul. But yeah, this was really good. And my mom also just finished this and she really liked it too, so appeals to lots of different age groups. So yeah, would definitely recommend this for an entertaining read. The next one I'm going to talk about, I'm so excited about because it was so good and I was really happy that I got my hands on it. I think I read it in like one sitting. And same with The 7 Husbands of Evelyn Hugo. Like, that was one that you like had to read in a day because you just wanted to know what happened. But anyways, it's Ina Robinson's Return of the Trickster, the final book in the Trickster trilogy. And I am actually gutted that this series is over. Like, I just want to know more about Jared's life and, you know, his character, I think, was just so well done that, like, he goes through so much bad stuff, but he's just such a wholesome being. And you just want the best for him out of life, you know? I mean, that doesn't always happen. But, yeah, I just think this is just such a cool series. And I think this book was a good way to end it, even though I really wish that there was more. But yeah, Ina Robinson is just such a talented writer, and I've just, over the last 3 books, I've just fallen in love with all the characters. And I'm honestly not usually a huge fan of series, so it's kind of rare that I got hooked on this one, but it's just stunning, fabulous. That's all I can say about this. Is if go read this if you've read the first 2 books. If you haven't read the first 2 books, go read those. Your life will be like changed, basically. The next book I'm going to talk about was another one that I just read this week, and it's Himself by Jess Kidd. And this book was so confusing. Like, I honestly just didn't understand the vibe. Like, even the whole way through reading it, I was like, what the heck is going on? It's basically like, an unsolved murder mystery kind of thing, but also with like half the people are dead, half the people are alive, and there's just like this really weird supernatural element that like feels like it doesn't fit in the story like at all. Like, I don't know, I just didn't really get why the supernatural part had to be there. It's also set in Ireland, I believe. Yeah, and I think it's by an Irish author, and you can just really tell in the writing, like the dialogue and like the language that is used, it's very Irish, so I think it was a little bit hard to get into at first. But I mean, with that being said, like I still had to finish this in like a day. Like I did want to know what happened, but so I think I almost, though, partway through was like, I don't want to finish this. Like, I'm just so confused. But I'm glad I stuck with it because I think I did get something out of this book. I don't even know. But, like, the mystery part was intriguing, but I think just the supernatural elements, like, really did not go in this story. But, yeah, anyways, I think I gave this 3 stars. But, because it was fine, like, it wasn't a bad book by any means, but it wasn't my favorite. Next one we're going to talk about is a kind of more fun, lighthearted read, and it is Get a Life, Chloe Brown by Talia Hibbert. And this one was so cute and so fun, and I actually only got this because I think this is like a romance, almost trilogy. Like it follows 3 sisters, and like each book is about a different sister finding love. And I heard such rave reviews for the latest one that has come out with the last sister, and I wanted to read that one, but I figured I should probably start from the beginning. And I'm really happy I picked this one up. It was very fun. It was a nice refreshing change because I'd been reading a lot of like more heavier books lately, so this was just a lighthearted, fun read. This was a little bit saucier than I thought it was gonna be. There were a lot of moments where I was like, oh, okay. I wasn't mad about it. And I think that actually Talia Hibbert did a really good job at like not making those kind of scenes like super cringy and like bleh. But yeah, I think I ended up giving it a 4 stars just because there were a few moments where the dialogue could get like really cheesy and like a little bit over the top. But for the most part, the story was really cute. I also liked the way that she represented chronic illnesses. Like it wasn't, like she did it in a non-cringe way, which I appreciate. So yeah, I will definitely be picking up the other 2 of these, and I feel like these will be fun to read in the summer and stuff, but, or just, you know, to have a fun break from this sad quarantine life. Alright, the next one I'm going to talk about, I have really mixed feelings about, and it's American Dirt by Janine Cummins? I'm gonna say Cummins, I don't know. But yeah, and I'm sad that this book is so conflicting for me because the author's name is Janine, so like we should have a bond. But yeah, so basically my thoughts on this book is when I was reading it, I thought that it was a really good story, and I'm not gonna say that I enjoyed it because this book deals with so many like really traumatizing things. So like it wasn't an enjoyable read, but it was a good read, you know? So like I was gonna give it like 4.5, 5 stars. Maybe not 5 stars, 4 or 4.5. But then I found more out about the background of the author, and I was really disappointed because this book is largely based on this woman and her child are having to flee Mexico because of a family tragedy, which like is not spoiling, it literally happens in like the first page. And it's kind of details like their harrowing journey to try and get to the United States, because they're trying to cross the border. And I thought that, yeah, the story when I was reading it was really gripping, but it turns out apparently the author is not Mexican and has no ties to Mexico and is basically just white, which is, for me, really problematic because, like, I have no idea, like, how accurate this representation is or if she's just basically, like, exploiting experiences of, like, real people. But, so, that's not my fave. Anyways, I was really disappointed in this book because I wanted to like it, but just with all the controversy surrounding the author, I can't, in good conscience, give it a good rating. All right, I only have a couple more left and we're gonna end on a more positive note. So the next book is Everything I Never Told You by Celeste Ng. And this is the author who wrote the book Little Fires Everywhere, which I haven't read the book, but I watched the TV show and it was really good. So I had high expectations for this and I think this was good. It's a really quick read, like it's really short. I can't remember if I gave this a 3 or 4 star review on Goodreads, but I think there was just something that was missing from this, like with the plot and like especially the ending. I don't know. I felt like this book kind of left me wanting more, but not in the way that like, oh my god, this is so good, like I want more of this story. It's like, it's more that it was lacking in some areas and I feel like there was just some stuff missing. It's not a bad book by any means. Like, it was a decent read, but I think there were parts that the story could have been maybe fleshed out more, and I think the mystery or aspect of it could use a little bit of work in that way. But I did like how it focused heavily on family dynamics. I think that's something I love to read and that's my favorite stuff to write too. So yeah, I would definitely recommend getting this book. Like, there's maybe it will work better for other people than it did for me, but I mean it was still good. It was good. Here I am trying to convince myself. But yeah, part of me kind of wants to read Little Fires Everywhere, but now that I've seen the TV show, like, I don't really have a lot of motivation to. But I would sort of like to read something else by her just to see, like, how her writing is different in other works. But yeah, I would recommend this. It was a nice, quick read. And the last book I'm going to talk about is another 5-star one, and I'm so excited that I got to read this. It's Thomas King's Indians on Vacation. This has been sitting on my shelf since like Christmas, and I don't know why I didn't pick it up immediately because I have loved everything I've read of Thomas King's, and this was no different. I loved this one. I think it was just classic King writing. And I thought the characters were kind of fun, even though they're really grumpy. But, like, the humor, you know, in it was good. And I think this was definitely a lot easier to follow than his other fiction book, Green Grass, Running Water, which I still loved. But you kind of, it's one of those books where Green Grass, Running Water, like, you have to read it, like, a few times to get all of it, because there's so many, like, references and nuances in it that, like, you miss a lot of it, and you kind of have to know, like, a lot about, like, I don't know how to say this, like, Indigenous culture and, like, or, like, Indigenous current events and historical events that have happened, like, to get a lot of the jokes and the references in it. Like, for Green Grass Running Water, there's literally, like, reading guides for it because there's just so much going on. It's, like, brilliant. But, yeah, you definitely have to, you know, really keep your eye on things. Whereas this was, there were definitely some references to things, but it was definitely a lot easier to read, I would say. So if you wanted to start on his fiction, I would start here and then work your way up to Green Grass Running Water, because it's more advanced, in my opinion. But yeah, this was a good read. I thought it talked about a lot of interesting things, and the representation of mental health in this too, I thought was unique. And yeah, just I love his writing and I loved this and I would recommend this to anyone. So that is it, my dudes. That is all the books that I've read in March, February. Although actually, the video that I did on reading books that I was supposed to read in school, I read the majority of those in February too, but like obviously I already talked about them, so I don't need to include them now. But yeah, so it was actually a really good reading month, at least March. February is kind of slow, but, and I'm still very much in the reading mood, so hopefully we will have a nice big one for April as well. Thank you so much for watching. Shout out if you stuck around till the end, and I will see you soon. Bye.